license and membership is a, getting her name, but she is a member of the MADAC, Mental Health and Developmental Diversity Advisory Committee. So, and they are aware of all the other activities going on as well, so we're trying to make linkages. We're also tying in with Samaritan as well, so that there's overlap there. So we obviously on steering committee cannot include everyone because then it would not be a functional group. But the way we're organizing things and with the multiple opportunities for public involvement, we're hoping that we will be able to make sure that all the strands are woven together. We have also worked to make sure that we call out homelessness and homeless population in this work plan, so that we can, wherever possible, identify folks that are going through the justice system that are homeless and that we are not overlooking that specific segment of the justice involved population.
There's a, you know, HOAC has a mental health work group, and then we have the Youth Mental Health Coalition. So that are both very active, and I just want to make sure that these folks are informed about what's going on.
Yes, and when we host the first meeting, one of the things that we'll be doing is putting together a list of all the people that are absolutely essential for the project team to interview. And so we will, I'll make sure to consult with you to make sure that we don't leave anyone out.
Commissioner Schuster, I recognize that you were referencing external agencies, and Commissioner Osro gave you a couple of examples. I would also like to note that we've had Mitch Anderson, our health department director, on board and involved in the steering committee throughout the process, and has helped along that line over the course of the last 3 or 4 months. So he's been intimately involved and has had input into the scope of work for both CGL and GOBI.
And juvenile director Matt Witherell has also been involved from the beginning.
Okay. And Danielle Brown is getting more involved in this.
Mm-hmm. Excellent.
Yeah. And then I have a question also about the facilities. That's going to be a separate process.
The intent is to emerge from this process with a plan that envisions three different scenarios of combination of programs and facilities that will meet the community's criminal justice system values and needs. What we may come out with is a law enforcement center, a regional jail, a local jail, whatever there works in order to put together the system that we as a community want to see. After that point, we would then need to move forward with design dollars in order to actually put together some sort of a hard concept and be able to price it out specifically. We will have at least preliminary estimates of cost of what these different scenarios would cost the county, but nothing is very final until you have actual designs.
Also, Commissioner, the county has done a number of studies and assessments over the course of the last 5 or plus years as it relates specifically to our facilities, and CGL and GOBI both are aware of those evaluations and will be provided with that information if they have not done already. So my point being is that we're building on work that has already been completed, and we're not duplicating our work that's been done previously.
That was my concern a little bit in terms of that we weren't heading off in a different direction, because I think there's been good work done in the past. And I think the most important part of what we're doing now is to really better inform the community, because we need community support to accomplish what we want to do. So in order to enhance the criminal justice system, it's going to take that conversation. And I think that's a very important piece. With that, Madam Chair, then I would move to approve the contract with CGL companies to conduct the criminal justice system assessment and authorize the county administrator to sign the contract. And I would also move to approve the and services for the criminal justice assessment and authorize the county administrator to sign.
I will second.
Okay, is there any interest in further discussion?
I have some hesitation, but I don't see any alternative at this point to going forth with this, so.
Okay. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed, none. The motion carries.
It's in your ballpark, Joe.
We'll be off and running before long, like tomorrow.
Yes, thank you. Next, we have a discussion and decision regarding property sale to John Boy's house in Rickettsville. Number 2015-557842. Mary Alley, hi.
Hi, Mary Alley, Finance Director. And the decision or the approval I'm asking today is for you to authorize the sale of a house in Elsie that's directly across from the restaurant.
It's next to John Boy's, right?
It's down the street from John Boy's.
That house.
The house that we foreclosed on a couple of years ago.
Yeah.
And we tried to sell it at an open auction and it didn't sell, and so we had actually three bids on it in a sealed bid auction. And John Boy, there's two John Boy organizations, John Boy. Anyway, one of the John Boy organizations, what is this called? John Alcee Mercantile. One's an Inc. and one's an LLC, so I think it's the LLC we're selling it to. They would highly.
This one says John Boy's Alcee Mercantile Inc.
Okay, this is the Inc., not the LLC. And it was very specific on how to do the deeds. We ended up selling it for, I don't have any idea.
$6,000.
$6,000. He, I think, is going to renovate the house rather than tear it down.
Really? Wow.
Yeah. So I just asked him for your approval to go ahead and sign the deed and get it reported.
Okay. Any discussion? Entertain a motion.
I move to put claim deed Benton County Tax Lot 14801DB TL 1000 to John Boy's Alcee Mercantile Inc.
I'll second. All in favor, signify by saying aye.
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 Thank you.
Motion carries. Okay, thank you. And we are moving on rather phase two. Our discussion and decision to renew the Benton County Clubhouse concessionaire contract with Gallery Catering.
It's
Lori Star.
Lori Star, Benton County Naturalist at Parks. Thank you. Good morning, Commissioners. I'm before you here today to discuss the renewal of the contract between Benton County and Valley Catering. This is the last five-year renewal that was allocated in the agreement in 2013. This would take the contract out to 2022. There's been just some minor revisions to the contract. Most of it was language changes that had not been incorporated in the last two contracts. There was county insurance requirements have changed, so those increases were included into the contract along with some maintenance items. One specific change that the Board of Commissioners had to the contract was to allow in the event of a disaster that if our county facilities were impacted, that the county would have the opportunity to move into the clubhouse. And that language was discussed with county council, and the concessionaire's council yesterday. That language has been agreed upon. Teresa Farley and Vance Grove have that language. If you would like, I can read that to you, but I believe you have it for you.
Who says that's not going to be unusable?
Well, it's
just in case.
It's another option.
It is an option. So the language was added to 2.1.23A, in the event of a disaster that impacts the county facilities as unusable, the concessionaire shall allow county operations to occupy the clubhouse for the duration of the disaster or until a suitable county facility is able to be occupied. In such an event, the county will prorate the concessionaire's monthly rental fee during that period and pay for all utilities and maintenance during occupancy. So that was the additional language that the commissioners have requested.
Thank you.
Are they going to cook for us all day?
She said since she wouldn't probably be doing any catering, she'd be more than happy to.
I have another question, Lori.
Yes.
I know this is the agreement to renew the franchise. I guess I would really like to have an update either today or another day in terms of what the improvements we've been doing out there are and what's yet to be done.
So the only, improvement, I have a laundry list.
I know.
A lot of them have been paid for by the concessionaire, not the county. However, the county did agree to providing an ADA access ramp, which has been completed. The only thing that's left is removal of some lattice on the south end of the building. It was blocking a lot of light. You know that we have 6 months out of the year that it's pretty dreary. So the request had been made, and it was also starting to deteriorate. So
yeah.
There's some additional improvements on the arbor on the backside that will be continuing to do improvements on.
And Mary plans to retire in 5 years, is that?
Well, I did ask her that question because she, you know, it's the end of a 5-year contract, and certainly in the original agreement back in 98, there was language that said the concessionaire proposed to the county an extension that it would be considered. That language was, I did put that language back in there, but there was actually 5-year extensions put in the contract, I believe it was in 2003. And I asked her if she would like to have additional 5-year extensions, and she said she'd probably be well into her 70s and would hopefully be retired by then.
So no plans beyond 2022, we'll just see what happens.
But this agreement is with Valerie.
Valley
Catering. Yes, and it doesn't mean that the business might not be sold to someone else.
Correct.
Yes.
Correct. So there is language in the contract that does allow Valley Catering to sell the business as long as the name is maintained.
Mm-hmm.
And there could be a transfer.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Ready for motion?
Yes.
I move to approve the Benton County concessionaire contract.
Do I have a second?
Second.
All in favor, signify by saying aye.
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 Thank you.
Motion carries.
Thank you.
Okay.
And Jonathan will make sure that is the most recent version of the contract that is put in front of the commissioner's for signature.
Thank you. Okay, moving on to old business. In the matter of approving the memorandum of agreement between the Fair Board and the Board of Commissioners. Linda McKee,
Benton County Fairgrounds Manager. Thank you for having us here today. As Vance Crony already began the discussion, we had an existing memorandum of agreement between the Fair Board and the Board of Commissioners that outlined the responsibilities of governance and the management of the fairgrounds. But it was determined that this was getting to be an out-of-date document. It wasn't representing how we were working. It didn't include the county administrator position, which had come into effect since we had signed it. And so we began an evaluation of it, reviewing it and updating it. And that included the Fair Board Chair, Trudy Overland, the Fair Board Chair, Vice Chair, Mark Baumgartner, Commissioner Zana Giroux, County Administrator Joe Kirby and myself. We all drafted a new memorandum of agreement that was reviewed by Vance Crony, the county council. And we all came to a point where we felt comfortable with the document.
And it was taken to the Fair Board during their December meeting, and it was reviewed and approved by the Fair Board. And one of the main items that you'll see changed is that it's organized now by operational area. And the original memorandum of agreement we had was very written in a very traditional way of fairgrounds in Oregon, that it provided the Fair Board all of the operational control of the fairgrounds and the fairgrounds manager. This new memorandum of agreement is more along the newer lines that many fairgrounds are going to, where it's more where the Fair Board is, they are operational over the fair, the county fair, but then they're more advisory capacity and the rest. And it gives the county administrator the supervisory power over the fairgrounds manager. And so it brings more discretion to the commissioners as to particular operational activities going on in the fairgrounds. And it and that kind of allows the fairgrounds to be able to expand past more the county fair and expand their services and things and stay aligned more with the county's full vision. So that was approved by the Fair Board in their December meeting, and it comes to the commissioners for review and approval here.
And I would add this, Lynn's exactly right. This is far, far, far more representational now of the actual operations of both the Fair Board, and our Fair Manager. But the point I want to make, I think it's important for us to, in 3, 4, 5 years, look at it again.
Absolutely.
To make sure we continue to have a document that's representational, because the old one, which was originally written in late 2000 by Pat Cochran, it did exactly what it was supposed to do back in 2000, but because we didn't pay attention to it, we drifted away from what the document. So it's important, I think, to keep in touch with that document and reassess it on a regular basis.
Absolutely.
Have you had a new a meeting with your new Fair Board members yet?
I have not. Monday will be their first meeting.
Oh, well, good luck.
Yeah. 3 new members.
Yeah.
Organization is going to be a key thing.
Yes.
Bring those motions out.
Yes. We've got to organize our walkthrough.
Okay. Yes.
Arjun?
Well, I'll move to approve the memorandum of agreement with the Fair Board.
Second.
Okay. All in favor signify by saying aye.
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 Any opposed?
No.
Motion carries. Thank you.
Commissioners, I would like to extend my thanks to Lynn. She was instrumental in working through this process and through a myriad of meetings and discussions. So, Lynn, thanks for your.